What's happening, y'all? Tired. Been out cutting grass for 2 hours. I worked all last night. Got up at 1 after sleeping about 4 hours. But I figure I'd tell y'all another story. This one, as you can tell by the title, is 4 bucks in 2 days. Deer dog hunting. This hunt kind of holds a special place in my heart because it's the last time that my family all hunted together as a group. Pretty much after this year, or the year I'm talking about, everybody, Uncle Chris died and everybody kind of went their separate ways. The next year, Granddaddy died and we lost the lease. Anyhow, on this particular hunt, we'll start on Saturday morning. Me and my buddy Michael Golden, he would ride with me and my daddy. And my daddy always turned out from one particular point on this block of woods. And this block of woods that we leased was 180 acres. And I'll give you a little backstory. The reason why we killed so many deer, or I killed so many deer this particular year, I killed 11 bucks and 9 does off this piece of property and one other piece of property, the one where I took y'all to the 8 point that I killed, showed y'all the curve, the persimmon tree. Between this piece of property and that one, I killed 11 bucks and 9 does that year. And it was the best year I ever had, best year I ever will have, the way the game laws work out now in Alabama. But no one had hunted this property since, at least with deer dogs, since probably the late 80s, if at all. I don't know if it was ever run, but all it was planted pines with a creek bottom that run through it, and on the backside there was peanut fields, big old peanut fields, and deer had all they wanted to eat. Anyhow, on Saturday morning, me and Michael got dropped off and we went to my little crossing. I knew where the deer cross there every morning when we run this with dogs. And Uncle Jim and Aunt Sarah, they went just over the hill to a oak tree, the oak tree stand as we called it. Daddy went and turned out. Cliff went around to the other side. There used to be an old library there. Cliff went over to that point. Well, Daddy turned out the dogs, and me and Michael, I'm 16 years old. My mama and Daddy would take my guns away, ground me, beat my butt, whatever, if I was smoking. So me and Michael, when we'd get out, we'd walk up that road, get to that crossing, and we'd sit there and smoke a cigarette. And we were sitting there listening to Mickey Dog bumping a little bit. Had Mickey Dog, Gatlin, and Cooter May. Don't ask me why Diddy named that dog Cooter May, but had those three dogs he turned out. And they was bumping along. Me and Michael sitting there smoking our cigarette, put our cigarette out when it was done. And about that time, Mickey Dog jumped. Son, he's tearing it up. All three of them's tearing it up, coming right to us. Well, me and Michael, I thought, at first they were going to go up to the oak tree and try to cross. Well, there was a hill there. Uncle Jim and Aunt Sarah was over the hill, so I said, start easing that way. Mike starts easing that away towards the oak tree. Well, then they turn and come right to us. And Michael is standing on the side where the dogs are supposed on the side the dogs is running, and I'm standing on the opposite side like an idiot. Well, Mickey Dog coming through there burning it up, son. And I see the side of the tail coming through the woods. Ba-boom, ba-boom. You can hear him coming through there. And me and Michael throw it up. I'm waiting because I can't see a good shot. I can't see him. It's real thick in there. And when he hit the road, Michael shot. Pow! And when he went in the woods, pow! I shot. And me and Michael run up there to him. And one of us, I don't think it was me. I think Michael ended up shooting him again just to finish him off. But that was deer one on Saturday. Caught the dogs up and we was done with that race. Well, the dogs was kind of Danny didn't want to turn them right back out again. He wanted to let them rest a little bit because they'd been on that race. So we go around to another block of woods on the same 180 acres. And me and Michael's going to make a man drive, and everybody's going to kind of get on their stands around the block and see if we can't push something out. Well, we walking up through there. Me and Michael's about 100 yards apart walking up through this block of woods. And we hollering, trying to jump something up. I'm walking along, and all of a sudden I hear the bushes just busting. And I see two bucks, a big buck and then a smaller buck in front of it. And they're running like this beside me. And this all happens in 2-3 seconds, I reckon. But I throw up, shoot the first one, shoot the one that's closest to me. And when I go to shoot the other one, he's behind a bunch of pine trees and stuff, and I couldn't get a shot. There wasn't no way I could shoot, and I didn't just shoot to try to wound one. I killed two. Technically, I was limited out for the day. $2 a day was the limit. Well, after that race, everybody kind of gathers up, and we all go talking, and we don't end up turning out the rest of the day. We kind of hang it up after that. It's about 12 o'clock. It done got hot. It was cold that morning, but it done got hot. That was on Saturday. Well, on Sunday, Michael couldn't go hunting on Sunday. His mama was real strict about him going to church and all that. He wasn't allowed to go hunting on Sunday. So me and Daddy and Cliff and Uncle Jim and Aunt Sarah all go over to the property. Daddy turns out in that same spot. Well, Mickey Dog was just kind of trailing down that branch right there. Them deer like to lay on that branch. It's real thick down there, and Mickey Dog just trailing down that branch, and I'm standing there at my little crossing right there. It was a washout there, sandy washout. They always cross right there, and I'm just standing there kind of minding my own business, and I look out through the pines and I see a deer, and I could just see little pieces of it, and it looks like a little deer. It's real low to the ground, easing along. I'm standing there looking at it, trying to pick a spot at it, and it's doe days in Florida. The Friday and Saturday was a doe days. They don't have so many. Used to in the old days hunting Florida, you only had two. They eventually went to seven. I don't remember back then if it was two or seven, but this was doe days. And I think it's a little deer. So I eased my gun up, and when I could see its shoulder, I said, pow, and shot, and it just dropped. Well, I just kept standing there about 30 minutes. Mickey Dog still trailing down the block. Ain't nothing really happening. After about 30 minutes, I walk out there. I said, well, I'll go drag it to the road. That way when we get done with this race, you know, the deer will be here. Well, I walk out there to get the deer, and it's in a big old briar bed about waist high. And I guess maybe that's what made me think it was a little deer. But I walked out to it. And I got up there stomping down the briars and everything and got where I could see the deer. And all I see is that right there laying there. I said, oh my God. That may not be a very big deer to a lot of y'all. The farther north you go, the bigger they get. But that's a good buck for Northwest Florida. It ain't a monster, but it's a dang good buck, especially for you to think it's a yearling and turn out to be a 9-point. It got a split brow tine. That's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Ain't really got no trash around the bottom. He's kind of crooked. You look at him like that, you can kind of tell maybe. An old crooked buck. But I walk out there and I see that later. I said, oh my Lord. I run back out there to the road. Uncle Jim and Aunt Sarah, they had come up to where their heads was just poking over the hill. And I went like this, big buck, big buck. Everybody pulled around there and wanted to look at the deer. We drug the deer out and we're standing there. While we're standing there, Mickey Dog, he's still doing his job, you know. He's still hunting for a buck or a deer or whatever. And Mickey Dog, Gatlin, and Cooter May went hit. I said, Diddy, them dogs is running. Ah, they ain't running yet. They just hot trailing. I'm telling you, Diddy, they're running. Well, I was shooting a Remington 1187 with a modified choke. And I took off running down the road. I said, they running, Diddy. They going to cross in that bottom down there. Nah, they ain't running. Hell, you crazy. And I took off running, got down in that bottom. And by the time I got in the bottom, I could hear the deer coming. Tearing through the pine trees. And dogs were just screaming right on top of me. And that old, it was a little bitty spot. I didn't know what it was. I just shot it for a deer. But when he hit the road, bah, I shot him and he took off running straight down the road. And when he went down the road, I could see his little horns. And he went and cut in the woods, bah, I shot him again. And I didn't know if I killed him or not because I didn't have a real good angle on him. When he first hit the road, I shot. And it happened so fast, it was almost like $100 buck. He hit the road wide open, pow, shot. And then when he turned and went going down the road, I think when I killed him, or what killed him was when he went to cut to go in the woods and I shot him right the shoulder. But Mickey Dog and Gatlin and Cooper May coming right on. And when they get there, I just follow in with the dogs, good following the dogs. And we run maybe 40 yards and old deer piled up, bled out, blood everywhere. And drag it to the road. And everybody come down there and that wound that day up too. Everybody had plenty of meat. We hunted for meat. Of course, we hunt for horns like anybody else, but as long as everybody got enough meat to go to the house, four deer in 2 days, that's plenty to feed everybody. Everybody went home with a good good amount of deer meat. But we ended up riding that. Back then, you put your deer on the dog box and you ride them around, show them off. And we still do it, you know. But we went going through Florella, Alabama. That's right next to where I grew up. We was riding through Florella and the police actually stopped us. Made a traffic stop on us just so they could look at the deer. But that was a good time. That was the last time we all hunted together. The next year, Uncle Chris died, and then the next year, Granddaddy died, and we lost the lead. Anyhow, I hope y'all enjoyed that story. That's the best 2 days of dog hunting I'll ever have right there. And I'll always cherish it because that was the last time we was all together.